Hello and welcome everyone. So now after understanding few basic terminologies on pre-stressed concrete, now let us try to discuss something on the types of pre-stressed concrete on different basis of classifications. So we are taking four basis of classification of pre-stressed concrete, and to begin with, the first one is the classification of PSC based on bonding. So there are two type of PSC. One is the bonded pre-stressed concrete and another is non-bonded pre-stressed concrete. Try to understand the difference between two, because sometimes we want bonded PSC and sometimes the tendons have to be protected from corrosion, because when tendons are exposed to the water or the moisture or external environment, they get corroded. And due to corrosion, their cross-sectional area reduces, and that affects the strength of tendons considerably. So to avoid that, we sometimes go for non-bonded PSC. Okay, what is the difference between these two? Actually, in bonded PSC, there is proper development of bond between the steel tendons and the concrete, just like in pre-tensioning, as we have discussed. Automatically there will be bonding directly, okay? But if we want to avoid bonded PSC, then we go for non-bonded PSC, okay? And in non-bonded PSC, tendons are not completely in the bond with the concrete section outside. So how tendons are protected from the concrete? There are method when we provide encasing on the tendon, a cover एक लगा देते हैं, एक seeding, जिसे हम seeding कहते हैं. तो अगर आप pre-tensioning कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, pre-tensioning में automatically अगर आपने seeding apply नहीं किया steel bars पे, तो वो क्या हो जाएगा? Bonded PSC. And if you want to make non-bonded PSC through pre-tensioning, तब आपको क्या करना होगा? उस पे एक seeding लगानी होगी, एक मटेरियल लगाना होगा, एक केस लगाना होगा, सो दैट द टेंडन रिमेन प्रोटेक्टेड फ्रॉम कोरोजन. एंड इफ यू वांट टू मेक बॉन्डेड पीएससी थ्रू पोस्ट टेंशनिंग, अगर आप पोस्ट टेंशनिंग कर रहे हैं जिसमें डक्ट्स ऑलरेडी बना होता है और आपको उसमें बॉन्डेड पीएससी चाहिए, तो क्या करना होता है? उसमें ग्राउटिंग करनी होती है, ठीक है? ग्राउटिंग मीन्स पासिंग द सीमेंट स्लरी थ्रू इंजेक्शंस, ओके? एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट non-bonded PSC through post tensioning, तब क्या करना है? कुछ नहीं करना. ducts में आप सीधे tendons को pass करो और jacks के द्वारा tight कर दो. you need not do grout in that case, okay? because automatically the product which we are getting is non-bonded. कोई bonding तो है नहीं, क्योंकि duct आपने पहले ही provide कर रखे हैं concrete डालने से पहले ही. कंक्रीट डालने से पहले हमने स्टील बार्स लगाया और डक्ट्स डाला, फिर हमने कंक्रीट डाला, ठीक है? अब डक्ट्स के तो एन्यूलर स्पेस अभी भी खाली है, उनमें आपको बस स्टील डालना है और टाइट करना है और जैक लगाना है बस, ठीक है? सो दिस इज द क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड ऑन बॉन्ड. नेक्स्ट इज द बेस्ड ऑन ट्रांसफर. नाउ दिस क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड ऑन ट्रांसफर इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. देर आर थ्री क्लासिफिकेशंस. वन इज द फुल pre-stressing, partial pre-stressing, moderate pre-stressing. अब देखिए ट्रांसफर क्या होता है. ट्रांसफर देयर इज थ्री स्टेज. वन इज द इनिशियल स्टेज, वन इज द ट्रांसफर स्टेज एंड थर्ड इज द फाइनल स्टेज. इनिशियल स्टेज तब है जब हमने टेंडन में टेंशन अप्लाई कर दिया, ठीक है, और अभी भी उस मैकेनिज्म के अंदर वो टेंडन भी है, कॉन्क्रीट भी है, ठीक है. Now we have to remove the PSC from that mechanism. So now we have to cut the steel bars connected in that mechanism. So at that time, the stress is said to be transfer, and that stage is transfer stage. और उस transfer stage पे अगर पूरा का पूरा tensile stress जो हमने दिया था tendon में वो transfer हो जाता है concrete में, so such is called full pre-stressing, 100%. बट मोस्टली ऐसा नहीं होता है, बट देयर आर केसेस व्हेन देयर इज सर्टेन परसेंटेज और सर्टेन डिग्री ऑफ टेंसाइल स्ट्रेस इज ओनली transferred to the concrete. So such is called partial pre-stressing. But partial pre-stressing में एक point जरूर याद रखिए कि इसमें एक limited degree permit करना होता है कि कम से कम at least 60% transfer होना चाहिए तभी हम partial pre-stressing के अंडर मानेंगे या फिर 70%. So a limited degree is there, given there in that case. And whereas in the case of moderate pre-stressing, there is no as such limit given there. You can just transfer the tensile forces from the concrete, and whatever amount is transferred, that will be coming under the moderate pre-stressing. और उसमें ऐसा कोई limit set नहीं होता, ठीक है? So this is the moderate pre-stressing. Now third classification based on the profile of tendons is very important to understand. देखिए मैंने बताया था आपको कि PSC is the concrete in which internal stresses are induced of suitable magnitude, और उसके बाद एक शब्द मैंने बोला था and required distribution and of proper distribution. ये proper distribution क्या है? Throughout the length of the member of PSC. This is provided on the basis of tendons profile. See, there can be three types of pre-stressing based on profile of tendon. अब tendon की कैसी profile रखते हैं? So, the first one is axial pre-stressing when the tendon is passing through the centroid of the concrete section. So, the centroid of tendon is coinciding with the centroid of the concrete section. You can see in this diagram. अभी आपको axial PSC का यहाँ पे diagram दिख रहा है. इसमें क्या हो रहा है कि tendon is in the centroid of the concrete section. Okay. Similarly, next one is the eccentric pre-stressing. Eccentric pre-stressing और भी कमाल की है क्योंकि eccentric, as the name suggests, there is some eccentricity. Eccentricity is the distance between one axis to the centroid, and that is represented by E. And you can look at this picture of eccentric PSC here at the bottom, and here we have provided the tendons at the bottom at a distance E from the centroid of the cross section, and when the tendons are stressed and when at the transfer stage, what happens? Pre-stress forces develops in the concrete zone at the bottom. Now, not only just compressive forces are generating, but also it leads to the development of bending moment. And that bending moment is in hogging in nature. Hogging, you understand? Hogging and sagging. Sagging means this shape of bending, okay? And hogging is reverse, like this. So, this eccentric PSC leads to hogging. Hogging bending moment, and that counteract the sagging bending moment developing due to the external loads. So this is the additional advantage in eccentric pre-stressed concrete. Now the third type of pre-stressing is concordant pre-stressing, and concordant pre-stressing are those cases in which cables or the tendons follow a concordant profile. Okay, so mostly in concordant pre-stressing we do not use steel tendons, we call them cables, because cables can take the shape of any profile that we have provided there. So concordant profile, you are looking at this picture here. Here we have provided concordant PSC, and here cables are provided in triangular profile. Here you see it, because the external load is concentrated in nature and bending moment diagram is like this. Okay, so in the similar fashion of bending moment diagram, we provide the profile of pre-stressing. If the external loading is uniformly distributed, then the bending moment diagram is like parabolic in nature. So in that case, we have to provide the profile of pre-stressing tendons or cables like a parabola. And this parabolic pre-stressing will counteract the bending moment, this parabolic bending moment developing due to the external uniformly distributed load. So this is superb, amazing benefit that we get in PSC. Now the next basis of classification is based on the axis. Now this is just for your knowledge that there are three axes in our Cartesian coordinate. One is the x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and when the concrete is pre-stressed only in one direction, such is the examples of uniaxial pre-stressing, and when we the pre-stressing in mutually perpendicular direction, x-axis and y-axis also, so that will be the biaxial pre-stressing. And in priaxial pre-stressing, pre-stress the concrete in all the three mutually perpendicular axes. Okay, and you can see in this figure here. Here is the one concrete section, and in this case, reinforcement is shown here, and this is the direction of pre-stressing force here. Here it is done in only in x direction, so it is said to be uniaxial PSC. All right. And the below uniaxial pre-stressing, here in this diagram you are seeing that pre-stressing forces are applied in both the direction, mutually perpendicular x-axis and y-axis. So such type of PSC will be biaxial. And now in this third diagram, which is little complex, because here we have done pre-stressing in all the three directions. You are seeing here longitudinal bars, transverse bars, and also the bars coming out of plane. So all those bars are here pre-stressed. Okay, so such a case will be a triaxial pre-stressing. Okay, so these are the four basis of classification of pre-stressed concrete. One is based on the bonding, in which there are two types further: bonded PSC, non-bonded PSC, and then we come to the based on transfer. Transfer we have three types: full pre-stressing, partial pre-stressing, moderate pre-stressing, and then it is based on the profile of tendons, and under it comes the axial, eccentric and concordant, and then the classification is based on the number of axes, and it is further classified into uniaxial, biaxial and triaxial. All right. So now, after understanding different types of PSC, and we have gone through several advantages, so we have listed all the advantages. The very first advantage is that the cross section is efficiently utilized in comparison to RCC, and here in this case a permanent dead load is almost counteracted, and that can be counteracted to the degree we provide eccentricity in PSC. Just now we have discussed in brief, and this we will try to understand also later on. And the third advantage can be that it is more stiffer under working loads, and they are lighter and slender members, and due to lightness their dead load also decreases. Okay, and here we get more resistance to shearing forces due to the effect of compressive pre-stress, so we need not to worry much for shear stress designs. Okay, and pre-stressing also improves the ability of material for shock absorptions or impact loadings, and they are more economical when we are going for design of longer span structures without any intermediate supports, and it also have got considerable resilience due to the capacity of recovering from substantial effects of overloading. And also PSC have got better fatigue resistance in comparison with RCC, and due to utilization of concrete in tension zone, there is a lot much saving in concrete and steel also. So the amount is also given here in percentage. Since there is decrease in the dead load of the structure, so subsequently the dead load coming on the foundation is lesser, and hence the cost of foundation is also less. But for design of pre-stressed concrete, the material requirements are special in comparison with RCC. So pre-stressed concrete requires a concrete with very special qualities like high compressive strength. And why this high compressive strength is required? Because concrete will also be subjected to that much higher amount of pre-stress when the pre-stress is transferred from tendons to the concrete. If we provide concrete of lesser strength, it will crumble and it will feel like a brittle material. So compressive strength should be higher. Okay, and concrete with low shrinkage is desirable because there is loss in the pre-stress due to shrinkage of concrete. And concrete with minimum creep characteristics, so when we will be studying the losses, so there we will also study the loss due to creep. So creep should also be lesser, and higher value of Young's modulus of elasticity should be there. So we can conclude that we have to use high strength concrete of almost ranging from M30, 40 up to 70. There is no loss in that. Even we go for the ultra high strength concrete, maybe M70 to M100. Okay. And as per the Indian standard code of PSC, which is denoted here as IS 1343, it says that for pre-tensioned PSC, we have to keep minimum compressive strength M40, and for post-tensioned PSC, we have to keep minimum compressive strength M30. Okay. Now, as far as the requirement of steel in PSC is concerned, PSC requires a steel with high tensile strength because the tendons will be subjected to tension which is of higher magnitude, almost 2000 Newton, like that. And those high tensile steel which are going to be used in the PSC, they usually contain carbon in higher percentage, okay? And they are hot rolled into rods and cold drawn through a series of dies to reduce the diameter and increase the strength. And they are commonly employed in PSC and manufactured in different sizes, nominal sizes from 10 mm to 32 mm diameter also. So we require high tensile strength of the steel in case of design of PSC, and you can see here the tensile strength, that is minimum Newton per mm square, this is the unit, megapascal. So we are targeting to reach almost this much strength of the steel bars here. So this is the nominal diameter here given, and this is the tensile strength in minimum that is given here. So this is really a steel of very high strength, and the elongation percentage is also kept very, very less. Okay. So the same thing we have taken from the IS codes, and you can see in the case of stress strain curves for RCC and PSC. So in RCC, we generally use mild steel bars or HSD bars, if you remember. And for mild steel bars, we remember we have used Fe250, and high yield strength deformed bars are of strength Fe415 or Fe550, okay, like that. But these two types of bars are not used in PSC, neither mild steel nor HSD. Bars. We even go for those bars which are having even higher strength than high alloy bars, and they are shown here by pre-stressing wire. And even more than the strength of pre-stressing wire is the strength of pre-stressing strand. Strand means a group of wires. So when the wires are grouped and made a cable, they get even higher strength than individual wires. So this much strength is achieved in those PSC wire of just diameter 4 mm. So you can imagine the strength achieved in the strand or the cables that we use in PSC. So normally we can conclude that we need material of very high strength in PSC, whether it is concrete or whether it is the steel. And although we have to incur higher cost for the higher strength concrete and higher strength steel wires or a strand, but eventually the structure that comes out is economical in the case when we are going for longer span design without any intermediate supports or without any deeper beams. So that is what feasible in PSC design only. So we will be discussing on different pre-stressing system in pre-tensioning and post-tensioning in the coming series of videos. So till that, stay tuned and stay safe. Thank you.